Photoshop is the industry standard for creating still images and for editing those images. Not the least feature of Photoshop is the ability for layers to be used with Final Cut. In this video, I'll show you how to set up Photoshop so that you can ensure those layers will work in Final Cut. I'm Bruce McBride, and my goal is to improve your knowledge and to speed up your workflow in Final Cut. If you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell. And the main feature that Final Cut would use from Photoshop's point of view is the layers feature. Now, there are a number of other applications that can handle layers, and they will do similar things to what you're about to see now. And they would be Pixelator and Corel Draw. Anyway, let's get on to Photoshop. The first thing we do is select a new document. And the key to this one is you want to make sure the background contents are transparent, that the color is RGB, and it's 8-bit. Now, if it's not RGB and if it's not 8-bit, this will not work. The transparent background is a good feature for you to have anyway. I've got one here that we've already created. And talking about layers, here are the layers on this particular Photoshop document. So the black headphones are on that layer. The word national is on that layer, and the green cross is on that layer. We also have, in this case, a white background that when you take that off, you can see the transparent showing through there. Now, the idea of keeping a white background here is that since it's a layer, you can always take it off when you put it into Final Cut anyway, but it's just there for convenience. So once we've created the Photoshop document, how do we save it? We come to the File menu and Save As. And again, these are important things to do. You need to make sure that layers are turned on, and you also need to make sure that it's a Photoshop document. That will be a .psd file. So once that's saved, then we can go into Final Cut and use this document. Let's import that file into the timeline and use the layers feature. So here's the file here sitting on the Finder. We can simply drag that and pop it into our project. And there it is up there. And you'll notice in the top left-hand corner, there's a little icon that gives a layer symbol. As we drag that into our timeline now, and we can see the combination of all of the layers showing there. Now, if we double click on this, it pops it open, and now we see the individual layers. So the top one here is the headphones, and that's the black layer. So if I were to disable that, that goes away, just so that you can see the effect. Now, what we can do with these is that we can animate some of these items here. So for instance, the center, that's the green cross in the center here, we could have that grow from zero. So if I select on that and click my transform and set a keyframe, then we can make that a really small plus. And then when we move through the timeline, let's take it to here and now increase the size of that. Then when we play this, the cross gradually grows. To add from that, we could have the black headphones slide in from the side and then join the green cross. So let's try that. We'll just decrease the size a little so we can drag that off the screen. And so if we want it to come back to the exact position, let's take the playhead to where we want it to finish. So this is where we would want it to be the normal size. So we will select a keyframe there. And then take the playhead back to the beginning and drag it off the screen. If we use the shift key, that will make sure it goes off in a horizontal plane. And now when we play that, there's the headphones coming in and the green cross growing. Let's have a look at this in the timeline with the rest of the video. Now, before we do anything, let's remove or disable the white background so that just the logo and the word mark will show. So if we move back to the timeline now, let's just play it through now.
I hope that gives you some idea of the various things that you can do with layers when using them with Final Cut. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial and thank you for watching.